Hello students and friends, welcome back to Learners Academy. I'm Nihal Bhatia. Today I'll be sharing my handwritten notes of chapter 8. Today is day 8 with metallurgy. Question number 2A of the board exams, give reasons worth 4 marks. For those of you who don't know, metallurgy is my favorite chapter since I studied this the most from science 1 in standard 10. This video is really very important for all the students who wish to crack their science papers with above 95%. In this video, I'll be sharing many tips as and when I come across a certain topic, a certain give reason or a certain concept or phenomena. So watch the video very carefully. If you want to pause the video, pause it, watch it till the end, rewind it if you wish to. Yes, it is possible to score above 95% in science, but only you need to follow certain strategies, certain tips. So without further ado, let's begin. Crack your 10th boards with guarantee, question-wise preparation for exams. Prepare all of these give reasons to ensure 4 marks from question 2A from all the chapters. There will be 3 questions asked in question 2A. You have the choice to attempt any 2. In chapter 8, we have 11 most important give reasons. This is the highest number as of now. So study this chapter very well. There is always a guarantee that a give reason has to come from this chapter, either in your prelims, in your second prelims, in your board exams. So now, without further ado, let's begin with the main give reasons. Get above 95%, yes. Okay, first, sodium metal is always kept in kerosene. Sodium metal is always kept in kerosene due to the following reasons. Sodium metal reacts vigorously with atmospheric oxygen and it readily catches fire when kept in open. Sodium metal does not react with kerosene and it sinks in it. Hence, to prevent accidents and to protect sodium metal, it is always kept in kerosene. Very simple and easy answer. Study it well. Let's move to the second give reason. Calcium floats on water on its reaction with water. Calcium floats on water on its reaction with water because calcium Ca reacts less vigorously with water. Hence, just concentrate over here, just pay attention. Heat liberated is not sufficient for hydrogen to catch fire. I had made a small mistake, so my mom corrected it. Hence, the heat liberated is not sufficient for hydrogen to catch fire. Hydrogen gas sticks to the surface of calcium metal and does not escape easily. Hence, froth is formed on this reaction of calcium with water. Let's move to the third give reason. Common salt has high melting and boiling points. Common salt has high melting and boiling points due to the following reasons. Common salt, sodium chloride, NaCl, is an ionic compound. Most important point, mention this because it's a property, it's an ionic compound, you have to write that. It is hard due to its strong electrostatic force of attraction between the two oppositely charged Na plus and Cl minus ions. It's already underlined in red pen. I'm again re-highlighting this because it's very important. I'll read it out again for you. It is hard due to its strong electrostatic force of attraction between the two oppositely charged Na plus and Cl minus ions. A large amount of energy is required to break the strong intermolecular attraction, that is the strong ionic bond. Hence, sodium chloride NaCl, that is common salt, has high melting and boiling points. This is a fabulous answer, this is an amazing answer and it's frequently asked. Teachers and students' favorite answer. Give reason 4. This one was very important, by the way. Give reason 3. Study this very well. Fourth one. Lemon and tamarind can make a corroded copper utensil shiny. Lemon and tamarind can make a corroded copper utensil shiny again because copper oxidizes in air to form a black copper oxide. The copper oxide reacts with CO2 in the air forming copper carbonate. This copper carbonate is a green coat. Tamarind and lemon are acidic in nature. The acetic acid CH3COOH and the tartaric acid present in them reacts with the basic greenish copper carbonate coating. I haven't studied science for a while, so correct me in the comment section. I think CH3COOH is acetic acid. If I'm wrong, please correct me. Okay, let's get back to the answer. The basic greenish copper carbonate coating and makes the vessel shiner again. Therefore, lemon and tamarind can make the corroded copper utensil clean again. Let's move to the next answer. Give reason 5. Metals are good conductors while non-metals are bad conductors of electricity. Very easy answer. We've been doing this since 5th and 6th standard, but here it's a little advanced. Study this very well. The electrons in the outermost orbit of metals are free to move throughout the metal when a potential difference is applied across the two ends of a metal wire of a metal. Electric current flows in it, forming an electric circuit. It's a very important point. Please pause the video if you wish to. I'll give it a bracket over here. Non-metals have the property of covalent bonds. Electricity and current cannot pass through them as their electrons are not free to move. Hence, metals are good conductors of electricity while non-metals are bad conductors of electricity. Very important. Study this answer well. Read it. I suggest you pause the video over here. Go through the answer. Take a screenshot. Give reason 6. The blue colored solution of copper sulfate turns colorless when zinc granules are added. The blue colored solution of copper sulfate turns colorless when zinc granules are added because zinc is more reactive than copper. In the reactivity series given on some of the page of the textbook, I don't remember, there is a reactivity series in this particular chapter. It shows that zinc is more reactive than copper. The zinc particles displace copper from its carbonate, forming zinc carbonate. So there's a displacement reaction which takes place here. As zinc carbonate is colorless, the blue color of copper carbonate solution is lost. This is the net reaction. Zn solid plus CuCO3 copper carbonate aqueous makes ZnCO3 zinc carbonate, which is an aqueous, and zinc residue, which is solid. It's a displacement reaction. Important. Let's move to the 7th give reason. A shiny coat of copper is formed on the iron nail when iron is dipped in copper solution. A shiny coat of copper is formed on the iron nail when iron is dipped in copper because iron is more reactive than copper. On reacting with copper sulfate, when the nail is dipped, the copper is displaced from its sulfate. The copper so liberated sticks to the surface of the iron nail. Hence, a shiny coat of copper is formed on the iron nail when dipped in copper sulfate. This again has a net reaction. Fe solid plus CuSO4 copper sulfate aqueous gives ferrous sulfate, which is an aqueous, and solid residue, solid remains of copper. It's again a displacement reaction. Important. See, in such chemistry chapters, it is very, very important for you to mention the chemical reaction if it's present. This has certain weightage in the answer and it's worth 1 mark. Okay, it's important to be mentioned. Now let's move to the 8th give reason. Cryolite and fluorspar are added to the electrolyte mixture containing pure alumina. This is my personal favorite answer because I had studied this answer very well. This is some page of the textbook where cryolite and fluorspar answer is mentioned. I had studied this page in the entire textbook very well. I had spent hours and hours. This is my favorite. Cryolite and fluorspar are added to the electrolytic mixture containing pure alumina because, wait, let me just change the highlighter. Alumina has a very high melting point, that is 2000 degrees Celsius. To lower the fusion temperature of the mixture from 2000 degrees Celsius to 1000 degrees Celsius, cryolite Na3AlF6 and fluorspar CaF2 are added. It also saves electrical energy. hence to increase the mobility and conductivity of the fused mixture, Na3AlF6 and CaF2 are added to the electrolytic mixture containing pure alumina. I have highlighted almost more than half of the answer because this is my favorite answer. Study this well. Since it's my favorite answer, I will always tell you it's very, very, very important. Let's move to the next give reason now. Pine oil is used in the froth flotation process. Pine oil is used in the froth flotation process due to the following reasons. In the concentration of an ore by froth flotation method, water and pine oil and a metal ore are mixed. Air bubbles are released in the tank, which forms a layer of froth on the pine oil. The concentrated mineral are wetted by the oil and they float on top of the froth. The lighter the gangue sinks to the bottom of the tank and wetted with water and settles down. Hence the ore is separated. I made certain mistakes in the answer, so there are corrections. Go as per the corrections because that's the perfect answer. Study this well. It's a very important answer. Read it thoroughly. Let's move to the second last give reason, the 10th one. Anodes need to be replaced time to time during the electrolysis of alumina. Anodes need to be replaced time to time during the electrolysis of alumina because oxygen liberated at the carbon anodes react with the graphite rods, which are again carbon anodes, and they form carbon dioxide. Due to this, the anodes are continuously oxidized and they get eroded very quickly. Hence, it is necessary to replace the anodes from time to time. Important, small, easy, precise. Study this well. Okay, before that, I have something written for you. I'll just read it out. Pay attention. From October onwards, start with at least 2 hours daily for science. This is minimum for science. And you can also make it 3 hours or 4 hours, depending on how your interest lies for science. If you wish to score more, definitely I will suggest 3 or 4 hours. You have lots of time due to the lockdown and due to the COVID pandemic. You are at home, schools haven't started, it's only online. So you have ample amount of time to pay attention to math, science and other subjects. October has already started now. You have to be ready and you have to work on with your timetable, and you need to finish your portion by November. November end, by 30th November, you need to be done with your portion. And definitely, yes, you must finish then and start with practice test, test series and exams. It is very important to give exams to know where you make mistakes, to know where your skills lie, and also get it checked with a proper teacher so you know what needs to be worked on, what are your drawbacks and what are your qualities. That's it. Thank you for listening to me. Now let's move to the last answer, that 11th give reason. Silver amalgam is used for filling dental cavities because silver amalgam is an alloy of silver with mercury. Amalgam is basically mercury alloys. This is in the last page of the metallurgy chapter. It is hard, non-toxic and shiny and a lustrous substance. These are the qualities. Besides, it has a very low melting point and it can easily fill in the dental cavities. Therefore, silver amalgam is used for filling the dental cavities. Whereas silver is a soft metal and it wears off on constant usage due to abrasion. Very important and easy answer, interesting answer. Thank you for listening. This is a very important answer. Now let me end the lecture. Thank you so much for watching, my dear friends. Keep smiling, keep learning, share all your knowledge and experience with your friends. Thank you for staying tuned, and also further stay tuned to Learners Academy. I'll be uploading more videos every day. Stay safe, stay healthy, like, share and subscribe. All the best to your 10th standard. Bye bye.